Hey, Chris Menard here. Couple other printing items. This has to do with setting the print area, printing a selection, printing grid lines, and a couple other cool printing tips. Let's dive in right now. So in this current Excel file, I actually have two lists on my screen. One stops at G, column H is empty, then I've got a completely different list. The printing issue is when I go to Control P or File Print, it is doing exactly what I told it to do. But I don't need that second list to be printed. So I'm going to go back. If I always need to print this range, I'm going to select it. Page Layout tab, and this is where you can hit Print Area and you can set the print area. Once you've set a print area, it will remember it. So now Control P. Perfect. I've already made this go from portrait to landscape, just to pop it back into portrait, back into landscape, and there I go. If I print this, come back in here, I can just do Control P and print it again. I don't need to do anything. Other options that I like, though, since I've set the print area, if I come in here to Page Setup, I can go to the Margins tab, and we have these options. Center on Page. I usually don't do vertically. That is going to do up and down the screen. Just to show you this, I'll hit OK to show you that. Back to Page Setup. Margins. I do like the horizontally. Click OK. Now from left to right, it looks great. Page Setup again. I could change my margins here. I'm going to go over to the Sheet tab, and this is where I can print grid lines. Perfect. Page Setup, Sheet tab. I can also do row and column headings, which I have used before. It'll do the ABC for the columns and the 1, 2, 3 for the rows. Really handy when this is in a PDF format and I'm walking through possibly a meeting explaining how does this number look in cell D23. I'm gonna go turn that off. Page Setup, Sheet. Column and row headings are now off, but I'm going to leave the grid lines running. The header and footer tab, I usually do this in the page layout in the bottom right corner, but you could come in here and do your headers and footers here also. I'm going to hit OK, and then I'm going to go back. So there is my print area. You can see that it's got a border around it. To remove the print area, clear. You don't need to select it. It will clear it. Now, if you need to print something just one time, but nothing else on the spreadsheet, highlight it first. And then when you do Control P or File Print, you want to tell it not to print the active sheet, but to print just the selection. So now this is all that will print with print selection, but I'll have to keep doing this after I print it so it doesn't remember this, like the set print area. I'm going to go back to print active sheets, and now we're back to two pages. Back one more time. Some of the features that I just did in page setup. Here are my margins to quickly change them. Here's orientation. Paper size, print area we looked at. Page breaks we've looked at. You can put a background on your file, and there is the print tiles, which actually opens up the page setup box again. Thank you for your time. Feel free to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Have a wonderful day.